Alright, so where am I here on this? Oh my gosh, the drama of the self-important inner city not happening, I'll say. Because the inner city builds, the infrastructure builds of an inner city are just a disaster. In an inner city, when I was already dissing urban sprawl going on all over the place, we have to look at that, what's gone on. You have like this little residential area, and then you're like, oh, we just don't want to drive downtown, it's just too far. And so then they build a little building here, another building there, and another building there, and so they start accommodating with more and more of these buildings. Okay, and so then you're like, oh my gosh, it's too much inner city for me, and so they back out another way, and they build more residential, and then they build their little set of buildings. So you end up with a city, and then another city, and then another city, just chain-linked cities with these residentials in between, and then the hazard of those inner cities, those cities linking into crime, and ruining all those residences. Okay, so this is our huge problem with drama here in the United States, all over the world actually, is just how do you stop the inner city, what do you call it? It's like an organism. It's like an organism breeder of terrible, just terrible happenings. All right. So I know I really didn't want to discuss this. I had other things to talk about, but I guess this is like a pertinent on my mind. And then there's a dream. There's a dream world of, you know, the Teletubby style. You know, it's like, okay, so I'm talking about this Euro center, this Euro, I mean, it'll be massive. It'll be a massive, practically larger than a stadium, maybe even larger than a stadium. You know, you start including more and more. You know, maybe just so huge. And so we're like, well, we have to at some point accommodate that this will look as a creation of another inner city happening. So we don't want another inner city beginning. So it's like, here's the residential, and then there it is. Oh my gosh, you know, I guess we're trapped in. You know, so that's the way it happens, another trap-in of a massive city megaplex, and we're not looking for that. So instead of a massive city megaplex, how can we do it? So when I go back, and I was looking at West Valley City of all places, I remember they had this old mall. It was like a, you know, just your regular mall, and it had lots of little houses dotted around, and it hadn't gotten, at that point, it had not gotten too crimeful. Okay, it was still like your regular, hey, let's just go to the mall, you know. Okay, so it hadn't gotten too crimeful. So the drama I'm seeing is if you take that type of a mall and you give it we don't want the city to, you know, take out five or six blocks of those houses and just say, well, that's it, you know, we're the new city. Instead, for this type of building, what was I saying, a Eurocenter, why not? We have to look at futuristic, and a lot of futuristic plans, sometimes they're just too out there, and they are mega city looking. So in a way, can we downgrade the futuristic plans and bring in more of the roof builds that are the live plants? So we'll put the parks, we'll put your business there, we'll put this Euro center there, you know, right there in the middle of a residential area. So it applies jobs to all of those people for maybe, oh my gosh, it could give them jobs for a good 10 miles around, at least, you know, just constant, you know, square radius or whatever. So, but then the roof of it, you know, make the whole, the roof of it absolutely a park. a walkable. Now we know we have live organism roofs and all of this going on. We have live plants and la la la. So that's really what I'm thinking of would work better, would be less of an urban sprawl situation. Maybe that's really been our problem. It's like you go with these tall buildings, again and again and again, and we just end up with a pandemic of fear. Oh no, I don't want to go downtown. You know, you end up cast in the shadows. Cast in the shadows of this building that is shut down and scary at night. You know, really scary. So what we're trying to do is and also we want it to hide in a way. We want it to hide. We're tired of looking at it. Aren't we tired? I mean, come on, everybody, we are tired of looking at these big galoppy. They're just galoppy buildings, and you know it. It's like, oh, whoa, whoa. You know, no, I'm not impressed just because you can bend your windows. I'm not impressed. Okay, so we're looking at a live roof. A live roof, not very tall, maybe only one or two floors, holding a live roof. And so it would be just like a massive mall underneath. And it will have loading area off to the side for any new products for what was available. Okay. So you have the American products available, and you have the European products available. So, and then you have the gathering, you can have special buses specifically, you know, from airport to that area. You can have special buses for the suppliers, for the people that, not the suppliers, for the buyers, okay? Because these are buying houses, and if you don't have a buying house for America, I don't know. You know, what are you feeding these people as far as their eye candy? What are you feeding them? You know, what is their reason to go to work every day? I can't buy anything fun. I'm tired of Asian plastic. Why should I? And I will say Asian plastic. I'm just tired of it, you know. You know, make something beautiful. And then maybe, you know, maybe that person has incentive, you know, to stay and work an extra hour one day. You know, maybe, you know, you just give that little extra incentive into the economy of a person's mind. You know, I want to save up for that, you know. Yeah, there used to be a time frame. There was a layaway time frame, and I remember my mother, she was really into it. She would put, like, my shoes, she would put my dresses on layaway. And they were special, and they were unique, and they were not findable everywhere. So in a sense, that time, yeah, we know that time is well gone, you know. We know we're just supplied heavily by the Asians. Heavily. And very little Europe. I mean, it was just, you know, maybe we have a few German companies that have really made the plunge over here, and they've said, okay, we have Braun. You know. Or Boss, or whatever. But when it comes to the truth and reality, you know, they really have to be the big hitters. You know, they have to be Renault. They have to be the big hitters if they're going to get over here. And so we've lost just a huge, huge supply group. And we've given our supply group over to Asia, because Asia just has made it simple. Yes, we make for you, you know, specific for you. So Europeans make specific for themselves. They haven't been making specific for America. You know? We don't want made specific for America. We want the European products. Okay, so I'm going back to Salt Lake now with a Teletubby roof. And I'm also going, yes, the reason being is the offering, they have the ski slopes there, you know, so it's a fun experience year-round for the buyers. I'm just liking it. And as far as the crime city, that region, it has not gone too crazy, you know, as such as many Californian towns and cities and extra areas. Okay, so that would be my design build choice. And when we also go back to like the Carcassonne region on the other side of the block, I'm just talking one product per, and so they're order houses. So you go and you look at it, you don't drag it out of there. You look at it and you say, yes, I'll buy one, I'll buy 10, I'll buy 5, I'll buy 50. Okay, so they're just going to be right there, like display houses, like the merchandiser marts, like the furniture merchandising mart they have in Vegas, that style. But no, not opening in Vegas, because Vegas is such already, you know, a no water state, you know. So anyway, so we're looking at this, the Teletubby roof style, a natural park, and it will have definite open hours and shut hours, and that's it. So it's not going to be like, hey, I'm going to walk around in this, you know, seedy area of town. It's not going to be that at all. The locals are going to be riding their bicycles on top. That is the secret. We supply the jobs right there, and yet we give them also that same beautiful park. All right, so you know what I'm saying. Okay, so Carcassonne, you can also see it because we already have the vent, the wind that just goes and goes and goes there. And in a way, that would even be more superior of building choice to have it subterfuge. Okay, and then you can keep the old ancient city of Carcassonne in its original state, and you're in the drive-by and going, yeah, that's cool, that is so old, that's amazing. And then you're like, oh my gosh, but they have the megaplex there. You just cannot see it. That is where we should be right now. Absolutely. All right, so that's that, conclusion. Okay, so you understand that? American products, European products, and they're product houses, and we swip and swap them as buying choices. I hope you understand that. Yeah. And to gather those little tiny, because we have lots of little towns I've been there, I've been to in Europe. I'm like, well, how do we gather them? You know, those little tiny artisans. You know, very simple. It's very simple. It'll be, can be, use the Marie system. You can go to the Marie system. You know, who are your local producers for this, or your local suppliers for that. And then these are our products and only the products we make. And those get submitted into the main organism of this megaplex of the Euro Center. Each Euro Center, so there's two of them. You know, so the one in America, the same deal. You know, has to be their original product, so nobody else's. Can't be something you purchase from Asia. It has to be something that is your product. So, So that's where I'm headed with stopping the inner city sprawl, and also creating an economic boom. All right.